Now I'm really pissed off because I just filmed a 10-minute vlog and YouTube screwed it up. I'm very annoyed. It said, error, error, bloody hell, error. YouTube, don't do this to me. I'm trying to do a vlog on Robert Bloch and Amicus films. I like to call it Amicus. I've always called it Amicus, but that is not correct. I believe the actual pronunciation is Amicus, but I prefer Amicus. So I'm going to mispronounce it just because I'm a dodo. Now, do you like my hat? I think it kind of goes well with the theme of death. Well, it should be rotting fruit. Anyway, Robert Bloch. He wrote many, I don't know how many screenplays he actually wrote for Amicus Productions. This film, The Skull, was based on his short story. It's a very difficult short story to find. It's not in... I mean, the finest collection of Bloch's fiction is the book from... It's called The Early Fears. The Early Fears by Robert Bloch. Published by Fellowgam and Brema. Where is that? And that book republishes the first two collections by Bob that were published by Arkham House. But The Skull of the Marquis de Sade. I wonder when The Skull of the Marquis de Sade was written. Let me put on my eyes and we shall see. No. I wonder if he wrote it for Weird Tales. I have the story in this British edition, The Skull of the Marquis de Sade, published by Gordon. Anyway, does it tell? The Skull of the Marquis de Sade, copyrighted 1945 by Weird Tales. So he wrote that story for Weird Tales. It was published in Weird Tales. We really do need... I mean, we just had Chaosium just published. That delightful collection. Mysteries of the Worm in a third edition. And that has some wonderful... That has all of Bob's Cthulhu mythos stories. Wonderful stories. Wonderful. But, The Skull of the Marquis de Sade is a difficult story to find. It has not, to my knowledge, been widely reprinted. So, I've had this fantasy for years. I actually discussed this with Bob, of writing my own sequel to his short story. And I've been trying to do this for decades, but the idea... Sometimes, you know, you have an idea for... that you want to write a story and that idea festers and festers in your brain for decades and you just cannot find your way into writing that story and you dwell on it and you plot and you dream and it never works and then suddenly by some diabolic miracle the idea comes to you in an instant and you write the story. I've been waiting over 2 decades to write this story and I still have nothing for it. This is a lace I haven't worn yet. Oh no, I lost my light. Anyway, that doesn't work. I'm going to have to turn on the bright light. Oh, scary! Ha ha ha! Smoke. Oh, Barbara Streisand, she sings on her new album, Smoke, It's in Your Eyes. Smoke, it's in your eyes. La 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 la. No wonder YouTube keeps screwing up my videos. They're so depraved. Smoke. Smoke, it's in your bleeding mouth. I haven't worn this lace yet. This is one I haven't worn yet. How will I wear it? Will I wear it like this? Will I wear it like this? I'm going to run out of time doing all this stupid stuff. Now, Robert Bloch wrote, I don't know how many screenplays he actually wrote for Amicus Productions Limited. I know what they call it because I have a letter. I don't have the actual letter here. I'm going to have to turn on the bright light again. Well, maybe not. It doesn't show up. Can't see it quite well. This is a letter from Milton Subotsky. It's from Amicus Productions Limited. The actual letter is in... I gave all my really important genre letters, the letters I got from writers and things, to my friend Greg. This is a letter that I wrote. Well, I wrote to Milton Subotsky in the early, was it the early 1970s? Yeah, because this response from him is 20th of May 1974. And it's from Amicus Productions Limited, Shepperton Studios, Shepperton, Middlesex. They even have a telephone number, Cherry 62611. And it's a letter from Milton Subotsky. You see that? Milton Subotsky. And I wrote him a letter telling him that he should read some stories by H.P. Lovecraft because I thought they would make wonderful movies. And he addressed it to Bill Pugmire Jr. at 5115 South Main Street. That's where I'm living now, and that's where I lived when I was a child. Dear Mr. Pugmire, thank you for your letter of May 12th. I have always found Lovecraft difficult to adapt for a film, but I will reread these three stories upon your advice. Sincerely, Milton Subotsky. But of course, like so many filmmakers, he found Lovecraft difficult, impossible. Which, you know, he should have got Robert Bloch to write, because he liked doing those anthology films. An anthology film by Amicus Productions of three Lovecraft stories with a screenplay written by Robert Bloch. Wouldn't that have been wonderful? I don't think Bob had a very amicable, is that the word? He mentioned once in a letter to me that I don't think they paid him very well, because he told me that from his dealings with the production company, he thought perhaps that Amicus was Latin for tightwad. So, oh well. The time has come for a new edition of the best weird fiction of Robert Bloch to be published. Preferably by Arkham House, but maybe... No! Centipede Press, Jared. Jared, are you listening? Jared. An omnibus of the fiction of Robert Bloch that would include the entire contents of the Fetagamon Brema, of his Arkham House books, and it would include the Skull of the Marquis de Sade. That story needs to be back in print. It's a wonderful story, and I, one day, am going to write a sequel to it. This is my favorite portion of the film, where you see the action through the eyes of the skull. The skull. The skull. Ooh, scary! Robert Bloch, read his fiction and you will dream delicious.